WABC Weather Lab. Here's Eric's forecast.
It started off like it looked like we might finally get a dry weekend day in, but unfortunately we did get a few of those isolated scattered showers to develop this evening, at least giving you maybe a few drizzles, maybe a passing shower in some locations, especially South Lafayette down into Vermilion Parish. But all that activity for the better part is beginning to come to an end, but I do think it'll fire up again, not only for our Sunday, but also into the new work week as we kind of keep that typical summer pattern going. So taking a look at the big picture on the water vapor, what initially kind of gave us a little bit of a break from the rain for at least a good portion of the day is because we continue to have this big area of high pressure, and it kind of slid a little bit more back to the west, bringing with it the moisture back towards the great Rocky Mountains. But you do see this dry slot that moved in. This is in the upper level, so that did prevent those clouds from getting too tall and getting those showers to go during the afternoon. You can really see that as we zoom in, that dry pocket of air that was moving down across the area, which kind of limited our activity during the afternoon. But as the temperatures began to fall and that got closer to what the actual temperatures were higher above, that did get some of those isolated showers to begin to fire up as we pushed into the evening. You can see that activity that moved through mostly St. Martin Parish, Lafayette, and down into Vermilion Parish continued with us through 8-9 o'clock. Still have one shower over the basin and towards Baton Rouge. Also got a couple showers still hanging on with us back through Calcasieu and up into Beauregard Parish. But I do expect this activity to continue to dissipate, and it should kind of fall apart by the time we head towards midnight. So it should be a dry night for all of us, and the clouds should begin to fall apart as we have that drier air in the upper levels. So that should start off with a good bit of sunshine for our Sunday, and I think through the first half of the day we do okay. But quickly by 1-2 o'clock in the afternoon, that's when we begin to get that activity going. So we'll go 30-40% chance for some hit or miss showers during the afternoon on your Sunday. Still, you might be able to get a little bit of a break, and it won't be until maybe the evening before Lafayette begins to see some of those. That's kind of what it's been seeming. It seems like everyone else gets the showers during the afternoon, and then Lafayette Parish, you get the rain closer to 5, 6, 7 o'clock in the evening. I wouldn't be surprised if that happens again for our Sunday. Clears out later on in the evening, to a dry start to our work week, but quickly by the afternoon, you can see that shower activity returning across the area, maybe a 30% chance for those isolate the scattered activity. So just kind of rinse, wash, and repeat the next several days, and it looks like that continues all the way through Wednesday before high pressure begins to build in by about Thursday into Friday. Out in the tropics, the system that we have been watching continues to fall apart as it runs into some upper level wind shear. National Hurricane Center dropping it down to just a 20% chance of development, and I wouldn't be surprised if it goes down to 10% or they just get rid of it by tomorrow afternoon as it continues to run into unfavorable conditions. We have this tropical wave off the East Atlantic, but it looks like that continues to stay out over the waters and not causing too many problems for those along the beaches. Out in the Central Pacific, tropical depression, Eric, now as it is beginning to elongate and weaken, now down to 35 miles per hour. Flossie continues to hang on the 50 mile an hour winds and heading towards the big islands of Hawaii, but it looks like it's going to brush more toward the north. Still could bring some heavy seas across the northern portions of the islands and maybe some heavy rainfalls, but right now not expecting a direct landfall. Also this afternoon, we had tropical storm Gill form with 40 mile an hour winds, but you can see it's very elongated, not really seeing a defined circle, and it's expected to run into unfavorable conditions and should dissipate over the next 48 to 72 hours. And then in the big picture, as we look off what's coming off of Africa, not really seeing any definitive waves, so it looks like things will calm down over the next 7 to 10 days, getting us into the mid part of August. So for the rest of tonight, we'll just call it a very typical night. Warm and muggy, 73 for that overnight low, and then for our Sunday, pretty much a similar story. 90 for the high, hot and humid, feeling close to the upper 90s, but eventually that'll give way to a 30-40% chance for some scattered showers. Decent rain chances continue through the first half of the week with temperatures in the lower 90s. But once we kind of lower those rain chances, the high pressure building by the mid part of the week, temperatures get up to around 92, 93 by Thursday and Friday, with a little better rain chances, unfortunately, return by next weekend.